You, if you really love your children, support the things that they love. So we are about what by eleven on okay, the overbearing to and the law to any non remarkable. Ever can and the treat it like they're still at home, they're still your children. So even though they are married, maybe your daughter, maybe your son. But you control that kind of people. Like everything about their life, you want to rule their life, and don't do that. Give that money, or you do that. Like you continue to control their life. Look, leave them to live their life. If you really love your children, respect their partners, and allow them to live their life, so they can plan their life. Because if not, what if something happened to you, but you're so busy controlling their life and they're living under your roof? And if something happened to you, what will they make out of the rest? How will they survive? Because they're so dependent on you. If you really, really love your family and you love your children, planning is key, like we are trying to, you know, share with us every day. Yes, let me back up again in the car. Okay, you know, they want to talk that way. Or life is going to be good. Yeah, it's good. Life is good. But for how long? Life is good. But if anything is right, what will you do? What about your children? What about the loved ones? If you really love them, I'm sure you wouldn't want them to be sad and frustrated and looking around and struggling when you move on or when you go on to the next life. I believe you will plan them well. And that plan starts with you today. You may go without the basic necessities of having chicken every day, but you're saving the price of that chicken to go towards your saving for another benefit. Mm-hmm. And you are having vegetables 2 days in a week. Or maybe fish on Sunday, not every day, because that is money and that is expenses. Maybe today you know, you can say, I can afford it. Yes, you can afford it. But that money, if you put it on the other side, can help you achieve your farm, can help you achieve a small canteen, can help you achieve something else, or can help you save for your children, can help you even save for yourself. Those are the things that you can. It's not that you cannot afford to eat well, but you are eating wisely and healthy to your family, like we always share. We have our Super Monday. We don't cook a kanadina. We use a potato in the boiling soup for them to have it with their soup. We have mele and miti. The only thing that I buy is tuna. We are trying to, you know, plant some mele. And we have, sometimes we are blessed with coconuts being sent home. And all those things. And I look around, whatever is there, then we make it. So we have mele and tuna. And we cook vondi, you know, to go with it, or cook kumala. And then we have our dal days. So Wednesday, we have a hearty breakfast and dal. So we have dal and porridge. You have only have those options. And if we are feeling to ourselves, that okay, you know, we have a little money that we can spend. So we buy sweet corn soup, or we buy, you know, egg corn soup, that we can have something different from the dal and the porridge. And the whole day on Thursday is on dal. And on Friday in the morning, we try and have healthy food like a soup. Or like now we've done it for consecutive two last Fridays. We have a sandwich bar of cucumber and tomato,
lettuce,
tuna, cheese, an egg, and everybody come, serve yourself. Okay, that's healthy. And in the night, and then we see whatever they yesterday, I cooked cabbage because we were cooking for the mission as well. Kito roasted to cook their dinner for about 20 plus, you know, mission or people that are living in Lovala. And as I cook that cabbage with the lamb chops, cavitiolo, so we're not going to cavitiolo, that kind of stir fry, not only just fit to the 20 plus, I also pack it up in pre-pack, ready for my grandchildren or for my whole family to have it for dinner. So one pot fit the 20, and that same pot feed my children or my family for the evening. And we had our sandwich in the day. So during the day, we always tell them, okay, noodle there, leftover bread there, serve yourself, do whatever you need to eat and whatever you need to do during the day, but dinner is there. So dinner is already packed, prepared with their name. And I tell them, if you want to have your dinner now, you can have, but switch. And then have your noodles and have your bread in the evening. Like what I said, we can afford to eat chicken. We can buy, yes, we can buy meat every day. But looking at the menu that we have now, not only it helps with our money that we can save, also help with the health of my family, that they can eat healthy. And that is the plan going back to you. Like what I said, you can be listening today, you can eat corned beef today. You say to yourself, I can eat corned beef, set aside every day, or I can, because you can earn it. I mean, you have your money, you have the strength to get that. But that money, even though you have plenty, you can always put it aside. That can add up to be something else, an additional to your earning or an additional to what you have right now. I'll give this time to Kaselebu to share whatever that he needs to share before we round up. We have 5 minutes of the time this morning on the Family Table Talk.
We can talk about the